Hello, everyone. This is Latia for you coming today with another scripture from the Lord. We are in Psalms 82, verse 8, as well as Ecclesiastes chapter 6, verse 12. Let's go ahead and pray and we can get started. Thank you, Father God, for this word, Lord. Bless your children, Lord Jesus. Only you can see the future from the beginning, Lord. Help us to be prepared by having you. Lord, we love you. We praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, you guys, Psalms 82, verse 8. Arise, O God, judge the earth, for you shall inherit all the nations. All right, so here God is bringing justice to the earth, right? Remember, justice is all about making things equal and giving everyone their just due, whether it be good or bad. Remember, our God is a very prudent record keeper. He keeps very detailed records of our lives, and at some point in time, justice will be served, right? Everyone will get what they deserve, get their just due. That's why it's important that we have a covering, which is in Christ, because everyone has sinned, right? Everyone has fallen short of the glory of God. So therefore, you need justice. You need Christ to cover you when justice comes. All right. And so it's a saying, arise, meaning to go up, right? Come up, Lord, arise. Oh God, and judge the earth. So we're looking at God as the judge of the earth. We know that Christ is assigned the duty of judgment of the earth. And it says, for you shall inherit all the nations. And we know that Christ is the one who will inherit the nations. So this is most likely talking about during the 1,000-year reign or after tribulation is complete. So it says, arise, O God, judge the earth, for you shall inherit all the nations. All right. And so this is completed today with Ecclesiastes chapter 6, verse 12. We've actually had this one before, but it's a little different when arranged here. It says, for who knows what is good for a man while he lives the few days of his vain life, for he passes like a shadow. For who can tell man what can be after him under the sun? So this is speaking about the future and knowing what good things there are for man, right? How do we know what is good? How do we know what is right? We use Christ as the standard. We use the word of God as the standard for our lives, right? And then when we do that, when justice comes, when God arises and comes to judge the earth, we will be up to the right standard. And that standard is Christ. The word of God tells us that we need atonement for our sins. And we have that through Christ Jesus. It says, for who knows what is good for man while he lives? We know that's God. God is the one who knows what is good. So he ever since the beginning, he has assigned to us a standard, right? He's assigned to us a level of living. With Adam and Eve, it was don't eat from the tree, you know, eat from all of these things, but don't touch the one in the midst of the garden, right? And so who knows what is good for man? It is God who knows. And it says he lives a few days of his vain life. So we know that that vain there is empty. It is unfulfilled. It is almost like the vapor. When you look up the word vapor, that word hevel, like a vapor, this vain life, it says, which he passes like a shadow, meaning it's so fleeting, right? It's ungraspable, right? It's empty because by the time you try to grasp it, it's gone. It says, for who can tell man what will be after him under the sun? The only person who can prophesy from the future standpoint is God, because he knows the end from the beginning, right? So all that we know about the future that is true comes from him. So it says, for who can tell man what will be after him under the sun? Only God can tell us those types of things, right? And that is the conflation today, is justice, is that when God comes to judge the earth, he's going to bring justice. He is going to make things equal and right. He is going to bring about what it is that is our just due. For those who have received Christ, that means he's going to judge and render to us the rewards, or it'll be weighed out on the bema seat, and whether it will be burned or be able to stand up to the fire. For those who don't have Christ in their heart and who haven't received him as their Lord and Savior, then they will go to the great white throne judgment and have to answer for the things that they've done in their body, right? All right, you guys, let's go ahead and pray. Thank you, Father God, for this word, Lord God. Only you know what is right for us, Lord God. Only you know what is good for us while we live the few days of this vain life. Our life is passing like a shadow, Lord God. Help us to live it to the best of our ability, occupying until you come, Lord Jesus. Who can tell us what will be after us? Only you, your word. We love you. We give you glory and praise. When you come to judge the earth, Lord God, help us to be ready. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, you guys, if there's anybody out there who would like to receive Jesus as their Savior and Lord, go ahead and pray this prayer with me. But more than anything, believe it with all your heart as you confess it with your mouth. Dear Lord Jesus, I ask you to come into my heart. I make you my Lord and Savior. Jesus, I believe you died on the cross, and I believe you rose again on the third day so that I can be saved. Thank you so much, Father God. Jesus, forgive me of all my sins. In your name I pray, Jesus. Amen. All right, if you pray that prayer and believe that prayer, then the Holy Spirit has come into you and sealed you until the day of redemption, and no one can break that seal except Christ Jesus himself when he comes to redeem his church. The Holy Spirit is in you to lead you and guide you into all truth, meaning he's going to show you the way and help you judge each situation and make the right decision for him. Let him lead you and guide you into all of this. Go out, find a church home, find other believers to be sharpened around. Go out and make disciples of all men. Go out and be baptized. Amen. All right, you guys, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May he make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you and give you his children as peace. Take care.